Hello, this is Kevin from InQuality ipDTL. I'm going to show you today how to run a ping test from a Windows computer in order to determine the reliability of your internet connection for consistent data packet delivery, which is what we need in order to achieve a stable audio connection in ipDTL. In the search box in Windows, I'm going to type CMD, which is short for command prompt, and that gives you this window here. In this window, I'm going to type ping and then space and ipdtl.com, which is our server in Dallas, Texas. And I need to tell it how many times to run the ping test. Let's say 500 for now. So you do hyphen n space and then the number of pings. So we'll say 500. And you'll see now we're getting some replies from the server immediately. This is sending data packets, one per second, across the internet to our server in Dallas, Texas, and back again. Now you'll see that the ping time here is, it's a fair amount, over 100 milliseconds, and that's because I'm across the ocean in the United Kingdom. If you're in the United States, then you'll find that the ping times are far lower. What I'm looking for in these results is any deviation. At the moment, you'll see everything's coming back around 120 milliseconds. However, if there was a problem on my internet connection, then I'd expect to see some spikes, some large differences between these millisecond times. For instance, it might say 190 or 200 milliseconds or more for some of the results. That's what you're looking out for, because that tells you that not every data packet is being sent and received in the correct order. And if those packets aren't being sent and received in the correct order, your audio stream will become jumbled up and you'll start to hear dropouts and glitches. Hopefully this gives you some data which you can then use as ammunition for your internet service provider. But first of all, check that everything's fine at your end. For instance, try running a test on a different computer, swap your Ethernet cable, try a different router or restart your router, and check that the connections on the back of your modem stroke router are all firmly connected. Any further information that you need on this, drop a note in our ipDTL users group on Facebook. That's facebook.com/groups/ipDTL users, and the helpful community of ipDTL users will be sure to help. Thanks for watching.